Bonjour, bonsoir, chers fidèles abonnés à Coup de Projecteur, votre émission préférée. Merci de votre attention pour vous prêter na émission Nabino Coup de Projecteur. Je sais que le Coup de Projecteur est allé à la Polon la Ramoulili, copé Sabino ba information, Oyo est allé à la source sûre. À notre dernier numéro, dont nous avions traité l'affaire Alpha Lukau, je crois que je vous avais promis, à chaque fois qu'il y a évolution, il y a dossier à faire Alpha Lukau, je ne manquerai pas, il y a que ça, là, bah, élément pour nous éclairer. Pégotal Sabino, place Makamouza Okenda, Madame Francine Gembe de la Belgique. Affaire Résurrection. Affaire Alpha Lukau au niveau d'Afrique du Sud, ils ont dossier qui est trop sensible, comme ils sont tellement sérieux. Mais après, analyse à la télévision nationale sud-africaine et tout ça, il est sorti du silence. Alpha Lukau réagit. Depuis hier, il y a sa réaction pour assez justifier. Amigaku mibimisa clean parce que éventuellement Moutounio sope soki ba za ko accusé et a ça quand même le droit il y a ko s'exprimer et le prophète le pasteur Alpha Lukau ya Alleluia Ministries a on a South Africa na Johannesburg précisément na Sandton a s'exprimer qui total aye nini alinga ka bibisa batou et après on va retourner sur notre plateau afin de pouvoir évoluer avec les quelques analyses toujours sur le dossier Alpha Lukau, affaire Résurrection, Lazare, deuxième épisode, mais version Alpha Lukau. Suivez, on se retrouve juste après.
Beloved, recently our church, Alleluia Ministries International, my family and I have been a target of a vicious and provoked attack from a fellow who presents himself as a freelance journalist. He claims to have a huge network in the media fraternity in our country, which he will use to attack and destroy us. True to his words, we have been flooded with calls from different media houses calling to question and to follow up on the story of this fellow. In his many allegations against us, Alleluia Ministries, my family and myself, he claims that we are unbiblical, that our members indulge in adulterous relationship, that Alleluia Ministries to him is a cult, and that I am a satanist who sleeps with virgin girls to get power. He went on saying that I have many illicit relationships and I have a child out of wedlock who seems to be disabled. He carries on saying that I have paid the woman, said the mother of the child, a great amount of money to keep quiet of the story. He had gone an extra mile to hurt my family, speaking and pointing sickness and disability in my family, in my home. He had spoken great length about my wife. To him, we are fraudsters. To him, all that we do is nothing else but for a financial gain. We have tried to approach him, to engage with him, so he may retract his allegations against us and stop his many insults against Alleluia Ministries International, the House of God, myself and my family. But all that was in vain. In contrary, he decided to expand this smear campaign against us on social media, on television, on radio. Beloved, this is simply wickedness. The Bible says the devil comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And Jesus Christ speaking about the church, he said, upon this rock I shall build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. This fellow went on now, expanding his campaign against us on radio, on television. He has been on the national broadcaster, SABC, where he made claims against our ministry and against my person. This prompted me to come to you through this video understanding that his battle is not against me, is against the work of God. All he's after is to discredit the source through which many lives around the world are being blessed by. He's hiding his bitterness and the hatred against us by saying that he's trying to do a good thing. His intention is to save believers from Hallelujah Ministries, which, as you know, is nothing but pure wickedness. This man has been sent with a mission that favors one master, that is Satan himself. The Bible says the devil comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But the good news is the Bible says, upon this rock I have built my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. We have laid charges against him, filed papers in court for defamation of character, and our lawyers are busy working on it. This is not the first time that this fellow has lashed out at the church. Hallelujah Ministries, Pastor Alf, are not his first target. We do not know who will be next. Therefore, we all have to stand as the body of Christ and say no to the works of the enemy. Whatever comes to steal and to destroy is of the enemy. Quickly, let me tell you what Hallelujah Ministries does. This year, it will be 15 years of our existence. We are a Bible-believing church. We are a Christ-centered church. The Lord has given me the privilege to be the founder of Hallelujah Ministries. And in 2002, we started Hallelujah Ministries with 40 people. Today, we thank God that we have branches all over the world. We have, in this church that are pastors, 17,000 people. All these people came because they have been warned by the Lord. Great effort is invested on a daily basis. We literally have people who do not sleep and work around the clock, bringing the gospel of Christ, teaching people about Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who saved us, paid the price by shedding his blood, and one day he will come to take the church that we may be where he is. This is our work. We spare nothing in the pursuit of the will of God in our lives, in the ministry. Thousands of lives are transformed. Thousands of souls are added in the body of Christ through Hallelujah Ministries. And it humbles me to see that God uses me in a particular way, through the power of God, healing the sick, setting people free, and that this is my ministry. With humility, we allow God to be God in his people's lives, and that this is what the enemy cannot take. This is what Satan is furious about. His attack on us has nothing to do with our chairs, with our songs, with the kind of dress we have, but is the content and the substance of our ministries. If you look around, thousands of men and women testify the goodness of God through Hallelujah Ministries. Even as this fellow attacks us, if you go through his publication, in the comment, you'll hear the voice of thousands of people that are standing against him, resisting his doctrine and his move against the church of God. We all have to be prudent in this time. Not only that, spiritually, Hallelujah Ministries has been a blessing to our nation, but socially, Hallelujah Ministries feeds the orphans, sends the underprivileged to school. We have an office with over 61 full-time employees who are in the payroll of the church. And beyond them, we have over 70 contractors who are paid on a monthly basis. We're trying to sustain lives in doing what God has said. Hallelujah Ministries International is not a fly-by-night church. For the past 11 to 12 years, we have maintained our books clean, having audited financials for every year until today. We do not expect everybody to agree with our way of doing things. But one thing is for sure, we are a church based on the word of Christ. There is no water given in our church. There is no dust thrown on anybody in our church. We present Jesus Christ the healer, Jesus Christ the savior, Jesus Christ the deliverer, Jesus Christ the author and the finisher of our faith. Since I have founded Hallelujah Ministries in February 2002, I had endeavored to combine both business and ministry. This is to sustain myself and provide for my family through my own hands I was the group managing director of an investment house right here in Sandton for 10 years. And in that 10 years, I had invested in various businesses out there, keeping shares so that I may be able to stand by myself. I have never received a salary from Hallelujah Ministries. Not to say that earning a salary in the church that the Lord had helped me birth will be a sin. No, but simply because in my value, I believe I can be of help in a different way. We have all been in school. We all have academic qualifications. We all have different capabilities and capacity. We can make a difference in many fields. So I chose to combine the two. But 4 or 5 years ago, I decided, because of the demand of the ministry, to delegate my business interest and remain focused on nothing else but ministry. I am called to be an intercessor. I spend my time on my knees, praying for the glory of God in people's lives. I am sustained still by my businesses, not by the ministry. Being called a con man, a fraudster, it is way out of line. It is my prayer that God may bring repentance to this fellow standing against us and to whosoever may be joining with him and being behind him. And to all of us, my prayer is that we may be strong in the Lord. Amidst persecutions and winds, remain focused, for all the enemy wants is to distract you, because he knows that God has a plan for you and for me in this season. We are Hallelujah Ministries. We'll keep on praying, and I want you to remain praying for us, that the Lord may see us through, that the Lord may give us his strength, that we may remain standing. I love you, and I pray that God may bless you. Bless Hallelujah Ministries, protect our family in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you.
Monsieur Massoudi depuis France, Paris. Madame Francine Gembe de la Belgique. Igor Louvela, y a Paris. Boyoki. Le pasteur Alpha Lukau, Amekiko s'est justifié dans le Nénaye. Mais le dossier est encore compliqué, de plus en plus compliqué, parce que bah, journaliste à télévision nationale sud-africain, là je cite ACBC, bah, ça qui descend. Na quartier Esika Owapi, le garçon, le Zimbabwean Wana, le soi-disant ressuscité, à Fandaka. Ses amis, même battu à quartier, Balobi, Bayokate Mukolomoko à Beli, Bayokate Mukolomoko, ce garçon-là à Koufi. Et ça qui na grand étonnement na Bango. Komona que baebi sabango to ba mona na télévision que ndeko na bango camarade na bango frère na bango akufi pe ba résister à partir ya église Alléluia Ministries par le pasteur Alpha Lukau. Donc na témoignage moko nazola kisabino awa, toujours des éléments tournés par nos confrères de la chaîne nationale ACBC awa na South Africa. Un de ses amis a témoigné, mais à Bombi Lombi, peut-être pour des raisons de sécurité. Vous voyez, même dans la chaîne, étrangère, Moussou Sedara, ceux qui m'ont témoigné à Lingi, Bamouna Fasna été, voilà, Bamouna Kaye, Batara Mosaïque, et ces messieurs-là, à sa camarade, il y a le soi-disant ressuscité, au Azolo Bakke, Batikala jamais, et alors jamais, qu'il y ait Bakke, Ndekona Bango Akoufi, tout à Bela, même à ta Kosu Kosu. C'est ce qui fait que le dossier Alpha Lukau est comme de plus en plus compliqué, parce que l'appareil judiciaire sud-africain a saisi le dossier Alpha Lukau au Ezali, tellement important pour la colonne de la Yango, pour la Koluka, pour éclairer l'opinion. Botala, tu vois qu'il y a un dossier Alpha Lukau, c'est beaucoup plus les images que beaucoup parlé. Suivez. Autant la nengue bana quartier na bango. Nengue ba témoigner que ba yebi dossier on a été. Et c'est ce qui rend encore le dossier il y a pasteur Alpha Lukau plus compliqué face à la justice sud-africaine. Suivez. Et on se retrouve juste après.
With us, neighbors and friends of an alleged dead man have dismissed his miraculous resurrection as a fuss. This after a video emerged of the controversial resurrection by Johannesburg pastor on Sunday. SABC reporter Makgaketla Mahlabe and camera person Herbert Mamela visited the man's residence today.
A community left scrambling for answers.
I just wonder what happened.
The alleged dead man, only known as Elliot, lives here. His alleged death and miraculous resurrection, a shock to many. To those close to him, this was too extreme.
It's all lies. This never happened. These pastors just want our money.
I'm not.
This is wrong. Our children are totally lost. We had people eating snakes, and now they're raising people. This is ridiculous.
This man, who says he's a close friend of Elliot, says he last saw him on Thursday, a day before his alleged death.
He never died. He was also never sick.
But was the miracle real?
His wife once recruited me to go and act at the church. They especially want people who can speak English.
And there is an incentive.
If you act your part well, they'll give you 1,500 rand or just 1,000 rand for your silence.
He was in a morgue for 2 days!
This undertaker has worked with corpses for over a decade.
It's unethical to have someone come for the body viewing with their mouth open. There's no shroud. What we call a shroud is that cloth which covers the deceased from the whole body in the coffin. There is no shroud. So you can tell that something was very wrong with this whole setup on how it was done.
Where is the media now?
Could this be a publicity stunt gone wrong?
Where is the media now?
Repeated efforts to get comment from the church again drew a blank.
You are not going to speak to the pastor. I am his spokesperson.
I've just said to you, I spoke to the legal team now. I'm on my way to church because I was going to come there anyway and have the meeting with you. I'll go up and speak to legal. I don't know now when it is going to be available.
Despite the controversy, it's still business as usual at the church. Margaret Mahlabe, SABC News, Johannesburg.
Peto continue koloba. Ezali mawa makasi mingi pona bandeko bazali kosala bandeko na biso ba pasteur, ba prophète, ba évangéliste, tout le qualificat, les qualifications bazala nango. Et essayons un peu de fonctionner de manière il y a droiture et il y a koluka ko suyé comme moi en zambété. Nous, on n'est que de Bapandisango. On ne fait que des analyses. Ce n'est pas la compétence de juger le pasteur Alpha Lukao. Mais bisuto ça, analyse. Pour nous éclairer l'opinion. Pour nous faire la mise sur l'opinion. Face à fléau Oto Bengi, Makambu, l'église. Parce que je vous avais dit l'autre fois que je ne suis pas athée. Mais je partage la vie dans le cadre positif. Il y a philosophe allemand Karl Marx Aloba, la religion est l'opium du peuple. Pourquoi opium du peuple? Parce que quelqu'un, ce qui assis à Ndimi, pasteur Naye, à Ndimi, prophète Naye, peu importe ce que les gens peuvent dire, ces gens-là continueront toujours à courir derrière ces pasteurs. Mais c'est vrai. Le pasteur Moussous Bazako a abusé la confiance de la fidèle Nabango. Bazako use Bango pour utiliser Bango au nom de Dieu. Et Baoyo Bazali, ba vrai serviteur de Dieu, va tomber victime à cause de la salianzambe Bazali qui fonctionne comme il se doit. Et aujourd'hui, ça crée un problème au niveau de South Africa parce que Basengi ensemble et voter loi pour balandé là-bas. Église surtout yaba étranger. Ndeko oyo a sali le kambo mutu mususu ba victime et que tombé ba mususu. Toujours dans le cadre de l'enquête, chers fidèles abonnés à Coup de Projecteur et à votre chaîne YouTube Congo Dialogue, ma confrère Nabisoya et SBC, toujours, ma Kitaki et Sikawapi, le garçon à Salaka, dans l'entreprise, dans la campagne à Salaka, même son patron s'étonne de l'information, il y a Moussalinaye qui a Koufaki, va s'écusier. Aza informé, Aébi Amouté, c'est un blanc. Pas trop de commentaires à faire. Suivez. On se retrouve juste après.
Now, the church has since been ridiculed, criticized, and threatened with legal action. Our reporter Slindi Lomasikane is tracking the story for us. And as she's managed to track down where the man in the coffin, the one who was apparently resurrected, has been working. Let's take you live to her now. Slee, good afternoon. Firstly, I imagine you had to do some digging in terms of trying to find this man's place of employment. He's become an overnight celebrity, really, right? So tell us, what do you know about him right now, and what do his employers have to say about the situation?
Definitely, Kathy, the man of the hour, identified in the video as Elliot, as said by the pastor, as he's performing that so-called miracle that we saw, that's really been making some shockwaves through social media, you know, receiving some backlash from the religious sector. And all we knew was that this man's name was Elliot and was supposedly dead for a couple of days before the pastor to perform that miracle. Now, we've done some digging, and like you said, we've managed to actually track down his employer all the way in Pretoria, and we understand that his real name, in fact, is Brighton Moyo, and he is a Zimbabwean national, and in fact was working in this timber company since around June 2018. Now, to give us more detail around that, I am joined by his employer, Vincent Amoroti. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, and just give us a brief history about what you know about Brighton and how the working relationship was with him here at your timber company.
He was a very nice guy, and he came here about 6 months ago to learn the woodworking industry, and he was very willing and very able, but he was always very smartly dressed, and he at Christmas party at the end of the year, he was one of the smartest. He learned very quickly, and we made him an assistant machinist where he was planing timber. He did cut the end of, just nicked the end of his finger, and it was like the end of the world. It took his confidence away for quite a long time. But he worked well, and he was a nice guy, and it was an absolute shock to see him in the video and to recognize him with his mouth wide open.
Tell me about that moment. Exactly where were you when you saw the video, and what went through your mind when you saw him and recognized him?
Well, we suspended him a couple of weeks ago for missing a Monday and coming late on a Tuesday. And he was suspended with full pay, but he never came back. And we wondered what happened to him. And one of his friends brought a video into the office and told us that Brighton had died. And I love my employees. We've got 50 guys here. And to know that one of them had died, I was shocked. And when I went to look at the video, and I saw him lying in the coffin, and I saw his mouth moving, I said, he's not dead. And then we saw him breathing, and then we saw him come to life, and those eyes looking all around, it was crazy. So it was a big joke.
Yeah. And tell me, I understand, of course, he was quite an avid believer in this pastor, in the church, very religious. He was a member, according to what you know.
He was a member, and they all talk about believing in the things and all that, but I believe his sister and his aunt and another family member are in the church. And he, from what I hear from my staff, he was trying to get people to come and do the act with him. So I believe he has done a stunt in the wheelchair where he got up and he walked away. And he tried to, what do you say, solicit some of the people that work for me to come and do the shows with him. So it's an ongoing thing.
So it seems that it was almost a part-time job, this kind of work for him.
I think so. And I think that's why he was here, to get the guys to go with him to go and act up on the thing.
All right. So you're saying you haven't seen Brighton since around the 4th of February.
Yeah.
Would you like to have him back?
I wouldn't mind.
Yeah.
It'll be a new guy. It won't be the old guy.
Thank you so much. All right. Just also lastly, did he give you any problems? Did he seem like someone who's strange? I mean, what kind of a personality did he have?
He had a very egotistical personality. So if you made a mistake and you screamed at him, he would throw a lip for about, you know, a couple of hours, and it would be difficult to get him to understand that the only way you learn is by making mistakes. So I think this mistake of him in the coffin, I hope he learns a lot, that God won't be happy with him, eh?
And lastly, how have your efforts been to try and track him down? What attempts have you made? Have you been able to contact his family, or have you maybe been to his house?
No, I haven't been to his house. I haven't been there, but we have phoned him on a number of occasions, and we have tried to find out where he is, to find out whether he's coming back or not, and to see whether we can replace him. And we're going to have a disciplinary without him here, because that's the normal way of doing it. But it's a pity. He was a good egg.
Yeah. Any last words for Brighton? Maybe just a plea to maybe come back to work?
Yeah, come back to work, Brighton. You're a good guy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Kathy, I'm now going to just walk you through into the timber company. We're going to be joined by one of the employees. I apologize for the shaky visuals. We're going to speak to Henk Swanepoel. I'm just going to ask him to come through. He worked quite closely with Brighton. Henk, thank you so much for joining us. Tell me exactly what you know about Brighton. You spent a lot of time with him. You worked closely with him.
Yeah, I did. Brighton was what I would call one of our star employees. Very, very smart guy. Always on time. Generally, you know, yeah, really, really a good worker. I'm very, very shocked at seeing this little clip that I saw. It was, you know, that was quite something.
Yeah.
Brighton's the kind of guy, if you ask him to do it, you ask him once, he does it. He's, you know, really, really a bright person. Yeah.
What did he specialize in, and did he speak about the church or the kind of work he did for the church?
Well, personally, no. We weren't really on a close friendship basis. I knew that he did go to church. There were some evenings where they had evening prayers. It's as much as I know about the church. Brighton was one of our planers. He was a machine operator, which is pretty specialized. He works on quite a dangerous machine, and he actually cut himself the other day. Did a little nick on his finger.
Yeah.
But he was okay.
Yeah. Now, a lot of people are angry at the video. Others find it funny. Do you think it's an issue, what he did there, faking his death possibly?
Sure. I would say it's a huge issue. If you look at the size of that congregation and how many people are there, and they're all there to be inspired, and they're all there to believe, and they do believe, and sort of, you know, leading them on like that, I think it's a massive issue.
Yeah, I mean, it's people's beliefs. You're playing with people's emotions.
You're playing with the soul. You're playing with spirit. You know, it's a big deal. You can't just do that. You shouldn't do that.
It's a bit of a dangerous game.
It's a very dangerous game, and I wouldn't have ever expected Brighton to do this.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah. And you haven't been able to get in touch with him either?
No, I haven't. We've been trying through his friends to find out what's happening with the guy, where he is. But no, nothing.
Right.
Not yet either.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, thank you so much. Kathy, I'm going to take you through to Brighton's place of work. It is a bit loud. That is why I decided to conduct the interviews just outside of it. And as you can see, it is a timber company. They specialize in woodwork and in making some glass as well. And so this is basically what Brighton did on a day-to-day basis. I am told that he used to work on one of these machines, in fact, which is responsible for soothing out wood. So as far as we know, nobody has been able to get a hold of Brighton Moyo. I'm making a plea for myself. I would love to speak to him. And if he is watching this, please come and speak to us, Brighton. We'd love to hear from you.
Slindelo Masikani, fantastic work out at the foyer, the place of employment, because he's not suspended just yet, the place of employment of the resurrected man, Brighton, as you've heard then, even an appeal from his employers that...
Voilà, nous sommes de retour sur notre plateau de coup de projecteur. nous éclairons. Nous avons changé. Tout banal, il y en a 50, tout le monde, il y en a 100, tout le monde, il y en a 200. Affaire Alpha Luka, il y en a 3000 watts, Madame France à Belgique. Alors, dans le dossier, il y a un élément qui est en train de se successivement. Dans l'émission de Salaki, dernière fois, il y a un premier élément sur Alpha Lukao. Il y a eu des réactions de par le monde. Les gens m'ont appelé, parmi lesquels nous avons le pasteur Massoudi depuis France à Paris. Il a eu le temps de m'appeler et à Lingi, à me transmettre un message à Naïe, Naba, fidèle abonné et à coup de projecteur. Message écho mais la banne en Zambé. Le pasteur Massoudi a parlé à travers le téléphone. Il m'a envoyé un voice dont je vous propose de suivre attentivement. C'est que le pasteur Massoudi veut exactement dire au peuple de Dieu face à ces problèmes. Oyo écho meli pasteur Alpha Lukao. Tout l'anda pasteur Massoudi depuis France. Un fidèle abonné et à coup de projecteur dont je salue l'importance à Zako attaché na l'émission Nabino ou à coup de projecteur na chaîne Nabino YouTube à bien Congo Dialogue suivant le pasteur Massoudi. Et on se retrouve juste après et on continue avec deux analyses toujours et encore toujours.
Faisant suite aux questions que vous m'aviez posées sur WhatsApp concernant mon point de vue sur les faux miracles que notre compatriote M. Lukao a fait là chez vous en Afrique du Sud, je voudrais commencer par vous citer Exode chapitre 20 et verset 7, un livre de la Bible. L'Éternel Dieu dit dans ce passage, « Tu ne prendras point le nom de l'Éternel ton Dieu en vain, car l'Éternel Dieu ne laissera pas impuni celui qui prendra son nom en vain. » Donc, dans ces passages, si on analyse bien, dans le sens spirituel, Dieu interdit à tout homme de faire quelque chose à son nom que lui-même, en tant que roi et créateur, n'a pas ordonné. Quand même les Écritures nous parlent de cela, il faut toujours attendre l'ordre de Dieu pour faire sa volonté qui est dans la Bible. Malheureusement, avec l'escalade des faux pasteurs que nous assistons ces derniers temps, beaucoup d'entre eux, qui se sont autoproclamés pasteurs sans être mandatés par Dieu le Père, se permettent de faire tout ce qui est faux pour se donner de l'importance aux yeux de leurs semblables. Comme je vous disais au téléphone, on ne se moque pas de Dieu. C'est qu'un homme sème, il le moissonnera sûrement à son temps. C'est une loi spirituelle que Dieu lui-même a instaurée sur la vie de chaque homme qu'il a créé sur la terre parce qu'il connaît bien le cœur de l'homme avec son penchant vers le mal et la fausseté. Suite de mon analyse, le fait de voir les œuvres maléfiques de M. Lukao commence à être dévoilé, c'est que Dieu entre en jugement avec lui pour montrer et dire à tous ceux qui croient au faux ministère pastoral de cet homme de prendre leur distance et de l'éviter sérieusement avant qu'il soit tard. Il a trop longtemps trompé ses semblables avec des faux miracles truqués, comme tant d'autres aventuriers, des singes qui sont en France et surtout aux États-Unis, où le dollar est roi, maintenant Dieu, dans sa préscience de jugement, il commence à dévoiler la face cachée de M. Lukao. Je suis sûr que dans l'avenir, Dieu dévoilera d'autres choses qui sont cachées dans la vie de cet homme, pour continuer à convaincre ceux qui les suivent aveuglément de prendre leur distance et d'éviter un ministère massonger qui ne vienne pas de Dieu seul. Enfin, pour terminer mon analyse, je vous conseille de chercher les membres de l'église de Lukao, là en Afrique du Sud, pour les avertir du grand jugement de Dieu qui va frapper cet homme-là. C'est une bonne chose pour eux de quitter cette assemblée-là, pour que les jugements de Dieu ne puissent pas les attendre. Bon courage, Monsieur Massoudi, Bin Olela, à Paris, France.
Et voilà, je crois beaucoup qui, pasteur Massoudi, maître Freddy, bien à nous depuis France, a fait le commun de justice. Et pour votre information, ce garçon, le Zimbabwéen, Et aux arrêts, il a été appréhendé par la police sud-africaine. Toujours Nakat Yaba, enquête Oyo Ifo et Salama. Ces Zimbabwéens est déjà arrêté. Et éventuellement, Tokoka Mwate, pour Tokoyo Kaba arrestation et Salama et Landama, si réellement, affaire Alpha Lukao et ce scénario monté, commandité par quelqu'un, je ne veux pas dire que c'est Alpha Lukao qui en est le metteur en scène, je ne sais pas. Mais c'est face ou suite à l'enquête, Nekoya ou Talisabiso, si réellement Alpha Lukao est impliqué dans ce scénario, ce qui Alpha Lukao, Azali clean, c'est-à-dire Azali impliqué dans ce dossier, tout au long de la dossier, on va toujours vous tenir informé. Et compte tenu, il y a dossier Zali Nanou na justice. Nous, on n'a pas à faire, à prendre la place de la justice. Mais sauf que, à chaque fois qu'il y a une évolution, déontologie oblige, je vais vous faire part, et avec de petites analyses, sans toutefois incriminer qui que ce soit. Et biso devons nous transmettre kaka information aux Zali na évolution, il y a dossier Alpha Lukao. On n'est pas de juge. Mais sauf que nous sommes là pour transmettre les informations, normalement, dans les déontologies, il y a Moussa Lanabiso et PCP, Tindibiso, tout ça. Là. Madame Francine Gembe de la Belgique, héritier minimum, il y a Suisse, Patricia Nzemene, il y a Canada, Tania Baza, il y a Kinshasa, moi aussi, il y a Mundu, il y a Kitoko, Jojo Mboli, moi, il y a Papa, il y a Mundu, Angolo. Basouni, Arnaud Mbouanga depuis Angola. Les églises. Toujours les églises. Et encore les églises. Papa Wemba Emba et Longi à Jésus. Et comme ils font des commerces. Et Longi à Jésus. Et Zali et Sika au Batouba. Comme ils battent ma pouba sa bananzam et mabe. Pour votre information, je vous dis que les Sud-Africains, ce sont des gens basamois compliqués en matière. Yamaramotelim Kosambela. Balini Maramorosambela Ming Mingte. Et ça s'attachera beaucoup plus à la religion, à Bango, à Italie, à Mingi, à Yabi Kibo Koko, à Bango, à l'église, à Yangwana. Alors, avec de pareils dossiers, ça ne peut que endurcir encore le cœur des enfants de Dieu, au Nzam, à la Posa Baya Verrier, mettant Bango, à Bouabi, au Moni, tout ça, à Nine. Voilà des aventuriers. Et pour votre information encore, dossier né na Ote Koloba, tantôt, Commission à Bango Balandelaka, sécurité à bas citoyens sud-africains, bas consommateurs sud-africains, n'est pas d'autre pression qui va voter la loi pour bas coincer bas église, surtout à bas foreign, c'est-à-dire les étrangers. Pourquoi pour Nabango et Bimi Loko Lakeur, les étrangers viennent s'enrichir na sol sud-africain au travers bas église Nabango pour Nabango et Bimi Loko bas escroquerie. Vous voyez? Nous, on n'est pas là pour juger Alpha Lukao, le pasteur, mais nous laissons la justice faire son travail. Et tout en a posandé, il y a qu'au fumolé là. Tout qu'au fumola ban a yanza me misou, pas comprendre les jeux. Rien à dire, pas trop à commenter. Je remercie tous mes fidèles abonnés à Coup de Projecteur pour l'intérêt que vous attachez à cette mission, pour l'intérêt que vous m'accordez et à tous ceux qui m'appellent. Avec la confiance que vous m'accordez, nous allons toujours faire un effort de pouvoir faire un bon travail pour votre plaisir, pour vous informer. S'il y a des suggestions, des remarques, nous sommes ouverts à toute critique. Le numéro est allé afficher dans l'écran abino. Appelez, partagez, donnez vos avis. Pour ceux qui veulent participer à l'émission, n'hésitez pas à appeler. On va faire des émissions. Vous avez une idée à partager, appelez, on va partager les idées pour que nous arrivions à pouvoir faire un bon travail, à donner un bon résultat. Et pas il y a Bino, bah, fidèle abonné à Coup de Projecteur, votre émission préférée. C'est vrai, on est humain. Comme on dit, la perfection n'est pas de ce monde. Il peut y avoir des erreurs, mais on a toujours besoin de vous, de vos conseils, de vos remarques pour que nous améliorions. Notre manière de faire le travail. Et c'est comme cela que nous sommes vers la perfection, bien que tout retouché perfection. Encore une fois de plus, merci. Et rendez-vous à notre prochain numéro. Merci à tous ceux qui me suivent. et de votre intérêt que vous attachez à cette émission. Madame Francine Nguem de la Belgique, Yahweh Amwana, Josué Boloa Cape Town, Ardon Dumbuang encore une fois de plus, Angola, Liaba Kwanzawana, Maître Freddy Paris, Thierry Eyo, Mobali Amoun Yamoulaï. À la prochaine. Merci.